Hello everyone and welcome to the new episode of Beyond Mirage. Today I have with me again Rohan. And in the previous episode with Rohan, we actually discussed a lot of deep things, I would say, about faith, fear, how do you consciously make an effort to choose faith over fear. And it was a wonderful conversation with him. And I would definitely ask you all to go and check it out if you haven't watched or listened to it previously. And today we are going to focus more on content that we are already consuming right now, right? If you are even watching this episode or if you are even listening to this episode, then you're consuming a content right now. And I felt this very important over here because we are surrounded by the content that we are generally living in this world, and उसे हम इतना consume करते जा रहे हैं, and we don't even know for how much time we are spending our time with. So I'm very glad to have this conversation with Rohan. Welcome Rohan again to the series and podcast of Beyond Mirage.
Thank you so much, Jay. Thank you. Happy to be here.
That's great. So Rohan, I personally believe that we are not consuming content. The content is consuming us. What are your views on this?
I think that's right. And I, in fact, I had put a post on this, I remember, on my Instagram quite a while ago, where I said that, you know, it's you are not using social media anymore. It is using you as a tool. And I think it's reached a point now where I feel that we have to be hyper mindful about the kind of content we're consuming. We have to be really careful about what we are watching and why, and especially on social media now, it's almost like all sorts of news, fake news, it's available at the tip of your fingers, and you're with a smartphone. Even if you're not interested in that news, some link will be suggested, or maybe a friend will send a YouTube video, or somebody will say, check out this post. It's important to realize that a lot of these things are propaganda. So it's not really about having an alternate viewpoint and an alternate perspective. Any kind of meme, whether it might be a political meme, or it could be something on religion, or it could be just any sort of news, there's always some agenda behind it. We don't live in times where news and information is balanced. A lot of people, I mean, aajkal if you see, people have literally everybody is, you know, either has some opinion on YouTube or some opinion on Instagram or some opinion on Facebook, and they're running their channels, which is great. That it's so nice to see somebody like you doing something different and actually having meaningful podcasts. But if you see most of the channels on YouTube, they're all talking about some political agenda of theirs, you know. Either they are analyzing the situation in the country, or they are, and these are all basically armchair critics, you know, not like any of them have that much of an awareness of the real issues. But that's how it is. It's up to us. See, content creators who want to sort of come up with all sorts of content, who want to mislead you, who want to keep you trapped in that whole game of stressing out and overthinking and getting worried about seeing a particular, you know, all these news pieces, all this information is a trigger. Mm-hmm. We have to realize it at a very deep level that these trigger something. A religion post is likely to trigger some emotion in you. A political party's post is going to trigger something if you believe in right-wing politics or left politics or liberal and all that stuff, you know, which goes on. You have to ask yourself that is this person peddling an agenda? And that can only happen once you're very aware about the kind of content you're consuming. So I would say, you know, these platforms, YouTube, Instagram, they can be beautifully used for meaningful purposes as well. It's up to you. You use them or you allow them to use you. It's entirely up to you.
Okay. Yeah, that's right. And frankly, I also believe that, as you said, that it triggers something in us. And it also actually, somewhere I feel it shapes a personality. The people that we follow on Instagram, or maybe the content we are consuming of whichever content creator is actually going to shape a personality. And I feel that the quote that we had, actually I had I learned this quote, or someone told me that you will be the average of 5 best friends or the 3 best friends that you have with you. And I think that quote is now shifting to you will be the average of 3 or 5 content creators you are going to follow. So that's the thing that I feel, and it's somewhere subconsciously impacting your mind, and it is creating that kind of triggers inside you. That if I, as you said about the religion post, and so how actually one should be aware about these things, because yes, it is impacting, we know one. Second is, how do we change it, or how do we become more mindful about this?
I would say, as a blanket rule, you know, Jay, you have to be very aware of anybody who's selling you an idea. You know, so it's very different, like a psychologist, a doctor, a writer, an artist, they'll be having their Instagram pages, and you know, they might tell you, like, they might be talking about themselves, their work, and very clear and transparent that, you know, we have the service that we're providing. If you'd like a consultation, if you'd like to get in touch with us, get in touch. Very fair, very transparent. It's a very, you know, clean relationship. But you have to be very wary about anybody who's selling you an idea, because they are trying to get into your head. They are trying to fundamentally alter your thought process. And that change might not always be for the better. You know, so nowadays I see absolutely meaningless political debates happening on social media. There is this one side which believes in a particular ideology, and another side believes in the, you know, the, so the left versus right versus center, then there's center right, center left, you know, liberal, woke, right wing. There is no end to it. You know, all those labels, all those terms, everybody wants to keep you trapped, and everybody wants to put a label on you, you know. Right. So, and you're seeing that with all these labels that keep going around, Bhakt and liberal and ye, wo, blah, blah, blah. These things have become so commonplace now that not realizing that whenever you put a label on somebody, A, first of all, it's insulting to put any kind of label on a person, regardless of their political belief, their religious beliefs. Nobody has a right to start labeling each other. And also, you have to understand that at a deep level, the system in general, whether it's social media, when you look at it from a holistic perspective, they are very invested in keeping you trapped. They want you to consume this kind of content. They want you to spend hours and hours reading all sorts of nonsense, engaging. I mean, you have to remember, I was seeing this documentary, which I recommend to all your viewers as well, on Netflix, called The Social Dilemma. It came out just 2-3 days ago, which talks about, it explains, and it do a far better job of explaining it than I can, because they're actually tech experts, ex-Facebook, ex-Instagram, ex-YouTube, who are actually talking about these issues. And they're saying how every single like of yours on an Instagram or a Facebook post, every single comment is monitored. Based on that like, based on that comment, they'll show you more such content, they'll keep you more and more trapped. And you don't know the reliability of that content. Just because a YouTuber has millions of views, or some comedian has, you know, millions of followers, it doesn't mean what they're saying is the truth. It doesn't mean it has any basis in reality. Popularity on social media is the worst indicator of the truth, according to me. You know, you could have somebody with hardly hundreds of people following them, but they might be saying the right thing, and somebody with millions who are misleading you. So you have to be very mindful about the kind of content you consume, and at the same time, don't associate yourself with any ideology, I would say. It's very important to be free of labels, be free of ideologies, you know, just be light about yourself. Why do you have to get so involved? In fact, I'm surprised so many 18, 17, 18, 19-year-olds have got so politically involved, and they already have formed their political ideology, they form the basis of their beliefs. Why? I mean, mujhe to yaad bhi nahi hai, when I was doing graduation, half the times I don't think I even remembered who was the party in power, you know. Right. Now it is such an obsession, and they want to talk about it, they want to fight about it, they want to comment, they want to name call each other, they want to call out each other on social media. It's not leading you anywhere, it's keeping you trapped, and that's what they want to keep you trapped.
Yeah, that's true. And about the social dilemma, yes, I also definitely recommend it to everyone, because I have just seen it yesterday, and it's a wonderful documentary. And second thing that you said about that, it's keeping us trapped and we are forming opinions. And somewhere it is actually leading us to say more cribbing about our life, more cribbing about the problems that exist. Instead of focusing on a solution-oriented mindset, instead of focusing on the positive sides of things, we are actually creating a society, or we are actually becoming a person who is starting cribbing about things. And then I relate that this thoughts to the secret or the power of a subconscious mind, which book says that what you think, what you speak, what kind of energy that you throw into the universe is going to come back to you in certain way. And coming back to this, but first I would like to say that the most important content right now, which is trending on social media, is memes. And as I said about these things, like whatever kind of energy that you're throwing out in the universe, that will actually come back to you after a certain point of time in your life. And memes, yes, though it is in a sarcastic way, though it gives you a temporary laughter, it gives you a temporary pleasure, but somewhere I feel that it is hitting our subconscious mind very badly, which we don't even know of. I don't know, because sometimes some kind of thoughts pop up in my mind and I'm a bit aware about these. And I trace back that, achha, ye thought aaya kahan se? Maine to aisa kuch kabhi padha nahi tha, kidhar kuch dekha nahi tha, something like that. And then I realized ki nahi, ye to wo meme tha na, wahan se aaya hai ye thought. So what are your views on this? Like, how memes are going to actually, which is very trending right now, how it is actually changing our life and how it is actually changing our mindset?
Yeah, hey, that's a great question. And I think that a lot of meme creators are also can be very naturally funny, humorous, without being insulting, without being necessarily political or religious. There are some who would, you know, create a rap or a music of something, or it, and that is lighthearted content, which if done properly, if they have no agenda behind it, it's fine. But a lot of, unfortunately, memes have now started to get abused. Mm. So people with a certain political ideology will use memes. People with a certain religious ideology will use memes. People who want to sell some sort of agenda, they want to bring their point, or they want to increase the maybe number of followers or fame on social media, they use memes to sell you an agenda, to sort of, you know, get into your thought process. And you're right, Jay, what you said was that once we have seen something, we can't unsee it. Right. That's the reason why you have to be so careful about the kind of content you're consuming, because if you have seen an image, whether it's funny or whether it's violent, but if it has some sort of propaganda associated with it, or if it's just an absolutely violent image, these are things that you can't unsee. Somewhere or the other, they will trigger emotions in you, and your mind has registered it. So when it comes to content consumption, the only choice we really have, Jay, is prevention. We have to be mindful about what we are exposing ourselves to. So if I was to give any meaningful tips, I am very clear-cut about the pages that I have blocked on my Instagram, the kind of pages, even people, you know, if people send me something which I don't want to see, or they want to sell me something on agenda, for me it's straight block. Like, I don't want to engage with this particular ideology, I don't believe in it. Because I know that even if I engage, even if I send a comment, somewhere social media has tracked me that this is my consumption, and they'll send me more and more of such accounts and such videos. And also, my point is, block, create content, interact and engage with like-minded people, with people who have, with people who don't have a particular ideology, but they are maybe spreading positivity, they're spreading happiness, they're talking about gratitude, they're talking about spirituality. And then to make, so, you know, people say get out of your bubble. I would say no, make a bubble.
Okay.
Make a bubble on Instagram. Make your healing bubble. Make it a space where when you log on to Instagram, all you see in your feed is happiness. All you see is gratitude, quotes, spirituality, maybe a nice talk by, you know, some speaker on Advaita Vedanta or any other religion also for that matter. As long as they're talking about peace, compassion, you know, unity, brotherhood. And that's what your feed should look like. And if you do that, even if you spend an hour or two, it's okay. It's no big deal. But if you're going to be spending a few hours on Instagram just on memes and just on political conversations and opinions, which are mostly never based on fact, they're just opinions, then you're draining yourself. What I call these things are, they're basically a consciousness drain. They lower your consciousness. They bring you down at the very base level of a human being. And that's not what your life is supposed to be. You're supposed to constantly grow in your consciousness. You're supposed to take your consciousness to a higher level. And unfortunately, these things are designed to keep you at a low level of consciousness so that you don't have to think for yourself.
Mm-hmm. Right. But somewhere I feel that these kind of things are actually, say, a testing criteria for certain things that you want to achieve in life. Like, for example, if you are sitting for a job interview, or if you are having some, if you're going out there for a job, or if you're starting something, then people do expect that you have a certain opinion about certain things. You should know about certain things. They don't know, they don't care about whether you are happy in life, whether you are a positive person in life, and whether you can do good things in future in life. They just want to know that whether you are analytical person, whether you feel that this is right or this is wrong. It is like the bubble is created in such a manner that you are forced to consume those kind of content, I feel. Like if you don't have an opinion, or if you don't know about what's going on right now in the world, then you are left out. And in the race of not being left out, we are actually pulling us down. That's what I feel. And so how do we actually, say, balance these two aspects?
Yeah, so it's not, it's, there's so, you know, if you want to be aware of things, if you want to be aware of what's happening in the world, if you want to be aware about the economy, about the government, politically also, it's okay to have an opinion. It's okay to have a certain worldview also when it comes to politics or a certain ideology. I don't think that that's anything necessarily wrong about that. Where the problem really happens is once you get into arguments and debates about it. That's a lose-lose situation, because you're putting yourself out there, you are going to make a comment, somebody's going to make a counter comment, then you're going to comment on that, and it's a endless debate, which basically it's a opinion versus opinion. Half the time it's opinion versus opinion rather than fact versus fact. Today with technology, you can take one sentence what somebody has said, edit it, put some special effects, put a music, kuch na kuch cut, crop, paste karo, and make the person sound like a total idiot. It's so easy to do that today. That's in true. Today's times, you know, you take a quote, you take a few sentences, you do a little bit of editing up there, yahan ka place wahan kar diya, wahan ka sentence yahan place kar diya, and by that time everybody shared it and it looks like this person has said something totally ridiculous. That might not be the truth, and many are guilty about this, and many who will be listening to this know also the kind of people I'm probably referring to. But this is how it is when it comes to now, you know. I would say not to not have a political opinion, but stay away from these kind of conversations, these kind of arguments. Don't engage with such accounts. Don't engage with such people. So to answer your question more specifically, at the workplace, in fact, what I have observed is that it's healthy when you don't engage in too much of a political discussion at work, right? Because that can also be counterproductive.
Right.
I knew of somebody way back, long back, before even I became a counselor and all, when I used to work, I won't name the company, but there was this person who used to have very strong political opinions and anti-establishment and anti-government. At that point of time, I'm talking about 2008, 2009, he was pulled up by the HR, and eventually he ended up losing his job because he used to only on Facebook keep ranting about government, keep ranting about that. And people are like, you represent a company, you can't have such extreme opinions. Mm-hmm. So I would say the better thing to be is to be balanced. And most importantly is, why are we so scared of saying I don't know? We should just say I don't know when somebody tries to have a discussion with us on something. Now when they want to draw you into a debate and they ask, what do you think about this? What do you think? You're like, yeah, I have to give this more thought. I don't know at the moment. I'm still haven't made up my mind. And avoid the conversation.
Right.
I would say, because people are waiting to draw you into a conversation. They're waiting to tempt you into, okay, now I have triggered something in him. So I can now start talking about my agenda. Then he will say something. Then I will say something. No, end it at the root only. Say, I don't know, yaar. Maybe that's your opinion. Must be right. I don't know.
Right.
you know.
That's a wonderful thing actually, like cut it by from the root, so plant ya tree banega hi nahi kabhi bhi. So that's the very good insight actually, I would say, and I think that I should also start adopting this from now. in certain things and I avoid certain things in life, but yes, there will be always a scope of improvement, I would say. Yeah. So yeah, I would also start.
Also Jay, it's important to know that you don't have to have an opinion on everything. Aisa kuch rule nahi hai. There's no written rule in the universe that har cheez pe mujhe opinion dena hi hai mera. You know, sometimes you can have an opinion. I keep it to myself. I mujhe nahi share karna, mujhe social media pe nahi dalna what I think about this particular thing. It's my belief. I will stick to it.
Right.
You know, why to get into this debate versus that debate versus so talk and this topic, that topic? You know, to give you a very small example, because it's such a trending topic these days. When we talk about justice for SSR in general, you know, that whole case which is happening now, and I see a lot of people on social media posting. Stop worrying about justice for SSR. Instead, worry about the economy. So I find that suggestion itself, although I might understand the intent behind it, I find the suggestion silly, because you are basically saying, stop worrying about this problem that you have no control over and replace it with another problem that you don't have any control over, right? I mean, you are sort of doubting the person's intelligence as to what they choose to get involved in. My point is, whether you want to get involved in the SSR case or you want to talk about the economy, that's your choice. You don't have to give them an advice ki nahi iske bare mein mat worry karo, iske bare mein worry karo. So now you have people telling you kis cheez ke upar worry bhi karo. Like, you know, that's also not your choice anymore. If you're worried about this, no, you worry about these other things. Fact is ki dono situation bhi aapka kuch control nahi hai. ना तो आप इकोनॉमी को सुधारोगे, ना तो आप एसएसआर केस को सॉल्व करने वाले हो सिटिंग एट होम. यू नो, यू हैव टू फोकस ऑन योर वर्क. यू हैव टू फोकस ऑन हाउ यू आर सॉर्ट ऑफ फाइंडिंग वर्क फॉर योरसेल्फ, हाउ यू आर बीइंग मीनिंगफुली एंगेज्ड, व्हाट काइंड ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट्स यू आर वर्किंग ऑन, हाउ इज योर लाइफ इंप्रूविंग एंड गेटिंग बेटर. एंड दैट डजंट कम विद न्यूज़ कंजम्पशन, दैट कम्स विद ओनली सेल्फ अवेयरनेस एंड सेल्फ अंडरस्टैंडिंग.
राइट. दैट्स ग्रेट. एंड लास्ट थिंग आई वुड से दैट एनी हेल्दी टिप्स फॉर content consumption.
One thing I would always say, like how I said now also, unfollow all accounts which are toxic in nature, which have propaganda, which have any kind of extreme ideologies. No harm in following pages which you sort of, your the message resonates with you and all that, but if it's extreme, if it's very, very one-sided, avoid those kind of accounts. I would say mostly avoid celebrity accounts, because you have millions of followers over there. You are liking random selfies and posts, and neither are they engaging with your likes, nor do they respond to your comments, nor will they ever respond to your messages. It's a very toxic power equation where one person is famous, has millions of people, and the other guy or the other girl is just sort of looking at that, getting happy, or maybe triggering something else, because these days you see perfect bodies and you see perfect complexions and men with actors with six pack abs and women with absolutely flat stomach and very thin. So these kind of things actually trigger body image issues in people as well. It might seem like it's just a harmless selfie, but somewhere it has registered. You know, why don't I look like this? Why don't I have a body like this? Why don't I have this kind of a smile or a complexion or a figure or whatever? And why to engage with such accounts? Why to even get them into your consciousness? Because once they're into your consciousness, then to remove it is hard. It's always better to prevent it. So I would say, one, you should do that. You should definitely be very mindful about the kind of people you're following. In fact, I would say that if you're on Instagram, you don't need to follow more than 100-150 good accounts. I don't even see the purpose of it, A lot of people are following so many accounts, 2,000, 3,000, 3,500, and there's just content clutter. Take the time out, get onto your Instagram, see whom all you're following, and don't be afraid to unfollow. Unfollow people who are not helping you grow, who are not helping you to grow in your consciousness. Another way to do, at least in the beginning, before you completely gain control of your social media usage, I think you should shut off notifications. Just shut off notifications of Instagram, shut off notifications of WhatsApp. let it be controlled. That jab main kholunga apna Instagram, when I will click on WhatsApp, that's when I'll see the messages. Rather than I'll just be sitting doing something meaningful, I might be meditating, I might be watching something interesting, but there'll be a ping and immediately I pause and I'm going to check ki phone pe kya aaya hai, kya kiska message aaya, who's going to touch. Take that away. Shut down your notifications. And then of course you have limited things like screen time and all, which all phones have these days, which measure what your screen time is. I find that sort of useful, not very much, but the biggest thing I would say would be to unfollow accounts which don't help you grow, and to turn off your notifications. Those are the immediate first steps that you can take.
Great. I think this conversation would definitely help, and I think people might be able to follow this simple steps and simple healthy tips for good content creation consumption on social media. And thank you once again, Rohan, for joining us on this and having a wonderful conversation with me over content consumption. And I think this will help our viewers and listeners to definitely take a step forward and grow in their life by consuming a healthy content.
You're most welcome, Jay. And I really love the work you're doing. I really appreciate it. And thank you so much for having me over. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Take care, Jay. Bye. See you.
Bye-bye. Bye.